The talented Mr. Morrison.
I'm here, I'm cool, I'm me got to get ya. Mathematical, I'm me got to get ya.
John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
John Lennon also got shot in the face. Go now on. Please let me save Don't that me girl stop. Before she gets shot in the face.
Assalamu alaikum khawateen o hazrat, this is your boy Khansab69 with a new playthrough. Hang on, let me see if I can pause the game. I don't know why my recording has just started. Hang on, let me pause the game and make the intro. I was actually gonna start recording from the first, I was gonna start recording from the actual like main menu screen, but for some reason I didn't realize I wasn't recording. So I've started the game. This is my first time starting the game. I'm gonna make my intro from here. So I'm finally playing this game that Mustafa has been begging me to play for so long. A new fucking playthrough. Yeah, it's been a while since I've played another solo playthrough on my own. I'm quite excited. My first choice-based game. Let's see how this goes. It's funny because I already did my original intro at the main menu, but it turns out I wasn't recording. So, yeah. Anyways, onwards. Oh, looks like I'm in the middle of a storm. She's just as confused as I am.
I'm trapped in a storm? How did I get here? And where is here?
Okay then.
Wait, there's the lighthouse.
The lighthouse.
I'll be safe if I can make it there.
Oh.
I hope. Please.
What if Willem Dafoe's hiding in the area? You never know. Look at this fucking game, yeah. Well, I can actually walk around too. Dude, this game looks sick. I mean, the graphics aren't anything special, but the atmosphere with the storm looks very cool. Anyways, let's carry forward, shall we? To the lighthouse. Man. Look at a bad storm. Already, this game has quite an ominous setting. And holy shit! Look at the size of that hurricane. My god. Bro. Sick. 1910. Dude, this storm is nuts. Average day in Florida, be like.
Come on, Max. You can make it.
Yeah, let's just head to the lighthouse then. This storm is nuts. Oh, cutscene.
Holy shit.
Yeah. Holy shit indeed. Wait, is King Ghidorah hiding in there? What's going on? I hear there's some supernatural elements in this game. Am I? Oh my god! Holy shit!
That was so surreal.
It was all a dream.
Little pieces of time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay, I'm in class. Everything's cool.
Oh god, I'm back in school.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller.
Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria.
Look.
Why Arbus?
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
This game's already preying on my social anxiety. I remember being the butt of everyone's jokes in class. What even is this? It's me looking at a bunch of pictures. Why would I show this to the class?
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as tortured, right? And frankly, it's
no,
bullshit.
I would not take a selfie in class.
Keep that to yourself. Seriously, though, I could frame any
one of you. I can't believe I still have this pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century. But I like it old school.
I'm not gonna look in the camera, because that feels like a bad thing to do in the middle of class.
What if Arbus chose to capture people with the height?
I haven't kept up with my journal as much as I should.
She had a brilliant eye. So she could have taken another approach.
I don't want to look at my camera because...
I should take a picture to prove I'm still here.
What do you mean,
plus, it's perfect for my portfolio. And I have to get my daily selfie quota.
No, you don't have to get your beat America.
And there was honesty about the
economic
conditions.
Oh no, the game's telling me to take a picture.
But a beauty in the struggle.
I'm gonna get into trouble for this.
You don't have beauty without a beat.
Fuck, I can't do that shit.
Which explains why
I love my analog camera. I should take a quick picture now.
No, I don't want to take a picture. It's gonna get me into trouble.
We've all seen that iconic shot of Kerouac on the balcony.
If anybody else looked at this, what would
they think? Now's not the time.
If you haven't, shame. Capturing the romantic urban solitude of the 20th century poet.
Shut the fuck up, you B-Tech miscandil.
Now,
you know what? Fuck it.
Contrast
the game's telling
Stark
me to take a selfie, I'm
going
to take a selfie.
Salvador Dali's surrealist photographs. Like Cocteau,
it's gonna get me into trouble,
but... Renaissance man. And it's... I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
My name is
Of course,
Max.
As you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist.
I hate this guy
The
already.
Point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
I did know, but I kind of forgot.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror.
Cute haircut,
now you're
by the
totally
way.
Totally stuck in the retro zone.
Actually, never Sad mind. Face. I fucking hate you.
Very good, Victoria. The Daguerrean process.
You're not gonna fucking get hurt in
faces,
trouble for
making
fun of me?
Extremely popular from the 1800s onward.
Teacher.
The
now
first American daguerreotype self-portrait was done by Robert Cornelius. You can find out all about him in your textbook, or even online.
Oh, it's recess.
And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Why is she so sad looking? Well, that was embarrassing.
Victoria doesn't waste a second kissing ass.
Tell me about it. I have known some serious ass kissers in my life. Not gonna say any names, but you know who you are. Shame on you.
Okay, that printer is amazing. I'd love to see how it reproduces my pictures. I could pump out a whole gallery show with that thing. When I don't suck. Someday.
Yeah, printers. Marvel of the modern era. Just look at this poster.
I love seeing Mr. Jefferson's awesome photos on these magazine covers.
It's like a painting. Pop wine is grunge. Okay, so we're in photography class, I take it. What's this?
That was amazing when Mr. Jefferson took a class picture the first week.
There's one.
Even though
small
I didn't want
class.
To be in the picture at all, it was fairly fucking cool to watch him at work framing us.
So it's like a photography club, not a photography class. And take it. Kind of like what New Lens had.
Damn, they have carbon fiber tripods here. The ball head even has a pan lock. God, I'm such a photo nerd.
Yeah, and I'm not, so these terminologies don't mean much to me. But, you know, that's pretty interesting.
so cool to see Mr. Jefferson's actual published pictures. Gives me hope.
Wow. Interesting. Nope. Okay, get away from the chair. The thing is, I'm so used to playing, like, I'm not used to playing these kind of games, so it's quite a new experience for me. Notebook. Look.
Even her school books are gift wrapped. I can't believe she made fun of me in class. What is she, 15 years old? Of course, Victoria has to have the bestest, newest, most expensive everything.
Reminds me of Hamza Ahmed. What's this?
Huh. This might make a cool shot.
You know what? I'm gonna take a picture of it. Yeah. To be a really good photographer, I gotta take initiative. Macro-wise, I just got a thing. Kate, sup, Kate? Okay, what was this?
Obviously, name? Blackwell spent bank on the computers here.
Let's use the
Looks
computer.
Looks like somebody was already working on this. Cool.
Okay. Also, I'm not a fan of the teacher. Do I really want to? Look, I'm not gonna go through that stupid woman's personal shit. That's not me. I might be a photographer, but I like to think that I respect other people's privacy. Hey, Victoria.
Look. Every time I look at Victoria, I feel like she's talking smack about me.
Hey, Professor. I don't like you because you didn't stick up for me in class when she made fun of me.
This is ridiculous. I always get so shy and nervous around Mr. Jefferson.
Excuse me. Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes. Excuse you.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Do I have to? I didn't have any time. So I don't have a picture with me, do I? Do I have to?
Do I have to? I just don't think it's that big a deal.
Max, you're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others.
That's right, finally, some motivation, some encouraging words. Alright then, later bitches. Okay, let's look at this.
Even in pictures, the forest around here always looks mysterious.
I can attest to that, IRL. The lighthouse.
You can never escape the lighthouse here.
So that dream that I had, was it the future or the past? Let's look at the TV.
Man, he even has the best plasma HDTV for a class monitor. Can't wait to watch some more documentaries on this bad boy.
All my ops love the LG HDTV community. Let's open the
fucking
door.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
Welcome to the real world.
Hot. Then I might send you a special picture.
Hello, Buffalo Bill. Haven't seen you in a while.
Because Max wants everybody to see how cute she is.
God, I do. This is bringing back.
I need a serious time out in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
Oh.
I hate that class.
This girl reminds me of when I was in school. Jeez.
She's Man. So fucking shy. She takes selfies with a giant
camera. Middle school was such a weird time in my life. Oh. Well. Okay, Life is Strange. Episode 1. Chrysalis. Heaven.
Evan What's doesn't up, Evan? Say much to me, but his photos are very cool. You,
American girls, it's sad to Taylor!
There's Taylor, always waiting for Victoria.
Courtney, what's up, man?
I think that's Courtney. She's such a slave to Taylor and Victoria.
Well, we're cool girls. What's up, Buffy? What's up, Violet?
Melissa's always texting, but she doesn't hang out with a lot of people.
Who are you? Just a random NPC. Justin, my man!
That's Dana.
Nice shorts,
yeah. I think his name is Justin.
Dana White. Stop ripping off all of your athletes here.
Dana is on my floor too. She's such an archetypal, gorgeous cheerleader. Mm. They must make them in a factory. I shouldn't be so catty. Dana is nice to me.
I guess. Oh, look, it's Fabian.
I've seen Brooke hanging out with Warren. She seems like his type.
Daniel! Oh no, he's getting bullied. I must save him. Daniel, no. Stand up for yourself.
Oh, Daniel. He's so nice. I wish I could beat the shit out of Logan.
Logan, leave him alone.
I hate bully jockstraps like Logan. And he's a Vortex Club member.
What is fucking stereotypical jock? Missing persons poster.
It looks like she's been gone for months.
Missing from Arcadia Bay. I assume that's the bay near the lighthouse. Date missing, 19 years old, 5'5". Tattoo on calf of a dragon and a star on the inside of the left wrist. Rachel Amber. You can't like cool Native American type earrings. Okay. Sorry, there's a lot of details here.
I wish October would last forever.
Oh, tell me about it. You know what, Mustafa? If you're watching this, you're a fucking bitch for missing the Halloween party in ninth grade. You a bitch. Just want to put that out there. Well, it was such a fun event, but no, you wanted to play Fortnite. Yeah, anyways. I love Mustafa. What's this?
Don't need a PC. Missed the Poetry Jam tryouts, and I did not steal that backpack.
Alright. Yeah, okay, sure.
That's so messed up. I should contact them to find out what I can do. As if I am.
Over the past decade, climate change has altered the Oregon coastline, including fish. Fauna decimates the state's fishing industry. Yeah, that's quite unfortunate. Okay, I'm not gonna get much out of, like, looking at the fucking vending machine. So, anyways. Oh, another missing persons poster. Now, this is a key piece of lore, I think.
I wonder what actually happened to her.
Oh, it's the same fucking bitch from before, never mind. Gun-free zone. Oh, that's
ironic.
Good thing
I left my AK at home.
Oh, you know what? I'm not even gonna comment on that. It's such low-hanging fruit. Jeez. Oh, Buffalo Bill. Miss Grant. Another Miss, yeah, it's the same lady. Principal's office.
Principal doesn't come out of his office much.
Yeah, he's masturbating to Lady Gaga photos, that's why. Hey, Trevor.
He's cute. I like skater boys. Too bad they don't like me.
You know what? She seems like a cool person. I would hang out with her. I would. Oh, Janitor Samuel, my man.
God, Samuel is such a weirdo.
Okay, you know what? Remind me. He kind of looks like a Nod. He looks like the guy from the UFOn ads. Anyone that has a goatee looks like the guy from the UFOn ads. God damn, shorty.
There's Juliet from my dorm. Yet another Vortex Club disciple.
Actually, never mind. From what I understand, whatever this Vortex Club is,
figures Juliet would be dating Zachary. Jocks sucked up in the Vortex Club.
Okay, let's stop fucking about and let's actually. Yeah, okay, we're supposed to go to the washroom. American girls in the
movies. No one can tell. Empty, good. Nobody can see my meltdown. Except for me.
You know, being in this, like, school setting again, I don't know why, it just. It takes me back, yeah. It takes me back. Juliet plus Zachary, love forever. Rachel Amber is a bitch. Oh, Rachel Amber's the lady who's missing, isn't she?
Now, who would bother to write that crap?
That's unfortunate. Sink. Use.
Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Fuck it.
So, from what I understand, that picture you... Oh?
When a door closes, a window opens. Or something like that. Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day.
Oh. Butterfly on the toilet. Must take picture. Well? Photo it. Quickly. Yes! Now, if I was to make a prediction, some mean girls are gonna come and destroy the camera. Uh-oh. Wait, is that a guy? Am I in the guy's washroom by accident, or is he in the girl's washroom on purpose? What is happening
right
now?
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three.
Excuse me, this is the woman's washroom?
You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss.
Oh, God.
So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself.
You don't know who the fuck I
am,
or who you're messing around with.
Where'd you get that? What are you doing?
Son?
Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more.
Now listen, I'm all for the whatever amendment it is about the right to bear arms. That being said, when some fucking punk-ass white boy shoots up another school, I can't stand that shit, man. Like, there's... whatever, I ain't gonna talk about politics in this playthrough.
More trouble for this than drugs.
Oh,
nobody
God, you're
would
done.
Ever even miss your punk-ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
No! Superpowers! I reverse
Whoa.
Time!
What the fuck? How can that be? I was in the bathroom.
What is this, Memento?
He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand. And then I was back here.
As he likely was. These pieces of time can frame us.
Holy
I already
shit.
Heard this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color to
Now shadow. Kate is being hassled again.
Oh no, poor Kate.
And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Oh shit!
Can you give me an example of a
Damn,
photographer?
I cannot believe this.
Capture the human condition in black and white.
Okay, if I'm
camera,
crazy,
buddy.
I might as well go all the way.
Bueller.
Diane.
Can I actually reverse time?
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Hold L2 to
because
rewind. Holy shit! I can visit dinosaurs.
Did it.
Can you give me
I
an
actually
example
did
of a
it.
Photographer who perfectly captured
I'm a
the human
time machine.
Anybody? Bueller?
Max, don't
Diane
freak out.
Arbus.
Not yet.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her
Keep
images
it together,
of
Max.
Spaces. You feel like totally haunted
my
by
My pencil
the
case
eyes
is still in the same place. When I took my selfie, Jefferson asked me a question.
Tortured, right?
If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
Keep
Guess
that
I'll take a selfie.
Seriously, though, I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation. Shh, shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
I know I'm not dreaming
of course,
this.
As you all know, the
it's
photo
real.
Portrait has been popular
I can tell.
Since the early 1800s. Your generation
so
was
I can
the
go
first
back in time.
For selfie expression.
I don't like your
what
paintbrush
is
beard,
isn't dead yet?
Sir.
The point
Can
remains
I save
that
her?
The portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
I gotta take a piss first, man. I feel sick.
I'm
That's
sorry.
The best excuse.
I feel sick. May I be excused?
Nice try, Max.
Excuse
but
me?
You're not gonna get away that easy. We can talk more after class.
You
Is
fucking
there
bitch.
Anybody
oh,
here
shit.
Who knows their stuff?
Jefferson wants to keep me after
Louis
class.
Was a French painter
and I need time to save that girl.
A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone.
तेरे से किसी ने पूछा है खुसरा
ना विक्टोरिया
व्हाट इफ आई रिवाइंड अगेन
दिस आइकन मींस यू लर्न अ यूजफुल फैक्ट इट मे बी एबल टू यूज इट
एक्सट्रीमली पॉपुलर फ्रॉम द 1800s ऑनवर्ड द फर्स्ट अमेरिकन डगेरियोटाइप
व्हाट द फक एल2 रिवाइंड फास्टर वेट आई डोंट
Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
That.
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody
Congratulations.
Has been reading
Now,
as well as posing. Nice
can
work,
I please
Max.
Go save that that poor girl?
The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular. Mainly because it gave the subjects clear defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters.
What is this?
Max is so far waiting.
Damn it, everything.
And guys, okay, don't good. Forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Max,
fuck you.
You are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Sorry, sir. You get. Wait, what's this? What's this? What's this? I mean, look, the bitch with blue hair can wait. Let me just look at that. No. I'm joking. Let's, everybody in class. I have to save her. Stop walking.
I see you, Max
Run.
Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until
my.
We talk about your entry. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I'm not avoiding. I'm not sure if I have. I'm not avoiding,
I'm
sir.
Not avoiding, just.
Biding time? Waiting for the elusive right moment?
Yes,
exactly.
You're a photographer. You should
Max,
know this.
Don't wait too long.
L1 to quickly. Wait, what? Why am I pressing L1? Your latest
competition, everybody in class.
Wait, your latest
in photos, so
your latest
you
action is representing.
I know,
fuck.
Mr. Jefferson. I just worked so hard on the shot. And I'm sure you know what it's like
you know
to
what?
Be
no, I'm gonna try escaping again.
I just really think.
I see you, Max Caulfield.
Son of
Don't
a bitch.
Even
Whatever, yeah.
Photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Okay, John
I'm
Lennon
on top
said.
Of it. I think John Lennon once said that. Life is what happens while you're busy.
So I can go
things.
Back in time and make better
Max,
decisions.
You're on fire today. All the right answers. Good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
Thank you. Now please let me go save that poor woman. Don't worry, blue-haired lady. I'm gonna walk very slowly.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please.
Okay,
please.
Okay, let's go. Let's go. No. R2. No, stop reversing time. R2 to move faster. Run! Where's the washroom gone again? No. Shit.
Science class with those nerds.
Yes. Enter.
Okay, Max. Retrace every step.
Just wait outside the washroom and don't and tell that blue-haired lady to like not come in the washroom.
I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in, and I took a photo.
That's right.
Leave them out of this bitch.
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself.
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with.
Where'd you get that? What are you doing?
Where did he get that? He got that from the Walmart.
I need a hammer to break it open.
Really?
To control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would
they? Take it!
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
No! Reverse it a bit.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they? No way.
Don't
kick him in the balls.
Touch me again, freak.
Run. Oh, I've done it. Oh no.
Another shitty day.
Oh shit.
That did not happen.
Oh, I've just made it worse.
I just saw a girl get shot and then saved her.
We're gonna reverse time again.
What the fuck is going on?
Oh no, I can't do it right now.
Do not freak out.
Oh god, has he massacred the entire hallway?
Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse me?
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something?
What is this guy's problem?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen. The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone and please turn off that alarm since that's your job.
This guy reminds... Fuck it, I shit on security as it is. Bullies, all of them. Hello, Mr. Principal.
You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my
Tell him about the
future.
Bitch with the gun.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You can always be upfront with me, Max.
He seems like a stand-up
or
guy.
Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
Report, Nathan. Hide the truth.
I just saw Nathan Prescott waving a gun around in the girls' room.
Nathan Prescott. You sure?
The
yes,
blue girl can
He was in the bathroom
proof.
Talking to himself with a gun. I saw everything. He was babbling like crazy.
Okay, slow down. Slow down. So now you saw this without him seeing you.
I was hiding behind a stall. I have the right to be there. It's the girls' room.
I know. I just want to be completely clear what happened.
Tell him about the blue haired
Mr. Prescott lady. Happens to be from the town's most distinguished family and one of Blackwell's most honored students. So it's hard for me to see him brandishing a weapon in the girls' bathroom. So what happened next?
Then he left. I ran out here wondering what to do. Are you gonna bust him?
This is a serious charge. I'll look into the matter personally.
Tell him about
Thank
the fucking blue-haired person who was also there. She's
this
another witness.
After what I told
we'll
you?
We'll continue this discussion
so
later in my office. Please go outside with the rest of your class now, Miss Caulfield.
Of course this academic drone won't do anything, since the Prescott family owns
This icon
Blackwell
will mean
now.
Your conscience your
Should
action will have consequences. You can rewind to change the outcome. Fuck that.
Don't wander around here. Get on outside.
You won't be able to undo your choices after leaving this area. Fuck that. You know what? I stand for the truth. I ain't gonna hide the truth from that. Are you crazy? You know what? Come what way. God knows that my conscience is clear, dammit. God knows. Blackwell Academy. Of course, the rich white kid doesn't get blamed for it. But if someone like me would... Oh, man. Fucking politics.
Nathan Prescott, please come to the front office. Thank you.
Missing person.
Rachel Amber. She looks so hopeful and pretty. I wonder what happened to her.
I have a feeling Nathan Prescott has something to do with it. Hold on, what year is it in this game?
Rachel Amber.
Tell?
She looks so hopeful and pretty. I wonder what happened to her.
Pictures everywhere. Can I rewind? Or am I just like... Okay, so I can't rewind anytime I want. Yeah, okay. Hey man, what's up? Stella! Hey, let's interact
with
the
NPCs. Stella. Hey, I know you. You're the new quiet girl in Jefferson's class. Isn't he incredible?
He who? Yeah, I think so.
I don't know.
So.
We're lucky to have such a famous teacher. And I actually love his work.
Fuck
Me
it,
too.
Let's make new friends.
His New York urban stuff is great, but I'm glad he came back to his Oregon roots. Screw the East Coast elite. It must piss off those pretentious galleries that Mark Jefferson is teaching photography to us Blackwell Hicks. Plus,
Hicks.
He is pretty hot for an older guy. If Victoria wasn't all over him, I would definitely make a move.
Whoa.
Victoria is pretty obvious. I don't think Jefferson is into her.
If Jefferson was into her, that would be
not the only
quite...
Now, how do you know this?
If Jefferson was
you
into her, that'd be
a
huge...
Here at Blackwell. Rachel Amber absolutely had sex with him.
Whoa!
Well, I heard that from a good source.
So, you knew Rachel?
That's interesting.
Not really. I saw her hanging with the other cool kids like Victoria. Not my kind of clique. but I heard insane stories about Rachel.
Rachel had graffiti. Now, this Rachel lady, someone had written like, Rachel Amber is a bitch on one of the bathroom stalls. So this random fucking NPC just has given us a strange clue. Rumors that she slept with our photography teacher. Interesting. Huh. Can I speak to her some more?
Hey, I'd like to study this photo, if you don't mind.
Oh yeah, that's fine. I guess the NPC dialogue's over.
Stella always looks so serious and dedicated. Good for her.
Fountain. Okay, sit.
This day has been so insane. Everything is happening too fast. And none of it makes any sense. These visions, this power. I keep expecting to wake up one more time. But if this is a dream, then I'm not asleep.
I'm wondering.
Which means somehow.
My actions are gonna have consequences. I told the truth about Max.
There has to be a reason.
Am I gonna end up getting into trouble because of it? You know what? I don't care. I spoke the truth. I stand by my decision. Now, I was discussing this game with Mustafa and Wali, and they mentioned something about saving someone. And it's really hard to do that. I don't know what they're talking about, but I'm quite worried. There's Miss Buffalo Bill again. Let me go talk to her. See what's up. Hello, Miss Grant. Oh.
Hi, Miss Grant.
Excuse me, Max. I know everybody loves being asked to sign a petition, but would you do Miss Grant a favor and hear me out?
Sure thing.
Sure, I always have time for you. What's the petition?
David Mattson, our chief of security, wants to put surveillance cameras all around the campus.
That cunty little security guy?
Gym, dorm rooms, etc. Blackwell Academy should be a high school, not a high security penitentiary.
I guess cameras could have helped Rachel. I can see both sides.
You're fair-minded, Max. And we all pray Rachel is found safe and sound, bless
us. Look, I know Miss Grant's
type. But this petition isn't about her. Blackwell Academy has a noble heritage. From the Native Americans who founded this land, to the pioneers who shared it in peace, not fear and violence.
Native Americans?
The Native Americans?
The tribes who were here first. Who welcomed the settlers.
You mean the settlers took it from them?
Both cultures found a mutual symbiosis and thrived.
I don't think that's what happened.
Now, before I assign you homework with this lecture, will you please sign the petition to keep our campus from going back to 1984?
Sorry, miss, but now look, listen. I know Miss Grant's type. She's a hippie little lefty who thinks that, oh, you know, if we all just sit in a circle and sing Kumbaya, all of our problems will be solved. No. Look, it's not like you're fucking turning this school into a fort. You're putting security cameras for security. That woman got shot because of it. I ain't signing your bitch-ass fucking petition. Fuck that.
Miss Grant, I totally respect your passion and knowledge, but some security cameras make me feel a little safer.
Exactly.
I'm not against security, Max. We should all be concerned when private space becomes public. Your generation has been tricked to think everything should be recorded.
We're in a school, you fat bitch!
Miss Grant sure is dedicated to that petition.
We're in a school, but you wanna fucking talk about private shit? Go do it in your fucking privacy. Oh, fucking Americans are, I swear to God. Warren. Okay, let's go through the... Oh, what's this? Sorry, whoa. Who's Warren? Okay, SMS. Fucking hell, SMS. That was also a thing once upon a time. Prologue. We have like things on everything. Interesting. The pictures. Dad, Kate, Mom, and Warren. I have a feeling Warren's the love interest, but. Let's go through the diary. October 1st. October. My favorite month. The best weather of the year. I love watching the leaves change color, turning into tiny flames, but it's still too damn hot. Thanks, global warming. And I can't bust out the big coats and sweaters or scary movies yet. Soon. Kate let me borrow the October Country by Ray Bradbury. I'm not familiar with that song, but I shall check it out after this. I haven't read much by him. Oh, never mind. It's whatever. Which caused Warren to almost revoke my geek cred before I held up my copy of Battle Royale. But he nails the autumn atmosphere of small towns. The last time I wore a Halloween costume was with Chloe. I have pictures in one of my old albums. I should find a real Halloween party to crash so I can experience some social mingling. It's that or a Vortex Club Stroke Fest swimming party. Sounds sexy. Or is that Backstroke Fest? You so puny, Max. At least I'm trying to climb out of my cocoon. I shouldn't expect my life to completely change after a few weeks of Blackwell Academy, as my parents love telling me on a loop, you have all the time in the world. Yeah, that's what we all think, isn't it? This does not exist. This will be the weirdest journal entry I would ever make. So weird, I don't know how or where to start. But it started like the most vivid dream of my life. Yeah, this is from the beginning. I saw a giant tornado headed for Arcadia Bay. It was so real I could feel the rain stinging my face and I was scared shitless. Then a boat hit the lighthouse and I swear I actually felt like I was gonna die. But I woke up in Mr. Jefferson's class and I wasn't even sleeping. I almost fell out of my chair. Jefferson called on me, but I totally blew the answer. Victoria being a fucking bitch. She's so awful. Yeah, I mean, we know what happened here. I felt so shitty. I just wanted to go to the washroom to be alone and wash my face after that nightmare, or daymare. Once I got to the bathroom, I saw this odd, beautiful blue butterfly flutter in, and right when I took a photo on it, the corner, Nathan Prescott came in, freaking out, talking to himself. I hid in the corner, and this punk girl came in, and they started arguing about drugs and money. My kind of gal. Then Nathan actually whipped out a gun and shot the girl. This is where it gets strange. When Nathan fired the gun, she reversed time. Okay. Major groundhog deja vu. Somehow I actually able to rewind time. I knew the only way to find out if I was having a breakdown was to go back to the bathroom and see if I could save that girl from Nathan this time. I had no idea how either. I just knew I couldn't live with myself if I let her die again. I escaped Jefferson this time by knowing exactly how to answer his questions and rushed to the bathroom. I hid in the corner again and couldn't believe it when Nathan showed up, freaking out all over again. Then the girl came to the bathroom and before Nathan could shoot her, I smashed open the ancient fire alarm and scared both of them away. Victory. Until I got grilled by that cunty little security chief, David Manson, who thinks he's Chuck Norris. Blackwell Ranger. Nathan Prescott almost kills a girl in the bathroom, but no, I'm the problem. I was so glad when Principal Wells stepped in to shoo David Weir. Principal Wells is a bitch-ass motherfucker, too. Then I made the most possibly fatal decision to inform Principal Wells that I saw Nathan waving a gun in the washroom. What do you mean, possibly fatal? I told the truth! I didn't think I should mention the girl or my new rewind abilities for obvious reasons. What do you mean, for obvious reasons? That girl is just is another witness. You could have used her to back you up. He didn't want to believe me and almost made me feel like shit for telling him that Blackwell's most biggest big fucking deal student would carry a firearm to class. That's just the thing, man. Fucking Americans, they don't care about no white boys waving guns in schools or malls. I couldn't tell him that he actually killed a girl in a previous timeline. So my school day started with an apocalyptic dream that ended with I'm just gonna go through some of the lore. My name is Max Scorfield, and I'll keep recording this, fuck it. My name is Max Scorfield, and ever since I was a little kid, I knew I wanted to be a photographer. I've always seen the world through my own lens finder. Maybe it's a way for me to be part of the world, but at a safe distance. For some reason, I always drawn to the old analog camera rather than digital tech. I love all kinds of styles and techniques, but for me, the instant camera selfie is the one I love most. I don't care if people make fun of me or not. I'm in great company, right? And now I've come all the way back to my childhood home to study photography at Blackwell Academy, a private school for 12th grade seniors. On a scholarship even, I originally left behind Chloe, my best friend forever. And it feels so weird to be back here without seeing her yet. So I'm 18 now, an efficient adult, even though I don't always feel so wise and mature. And I'm ready to begin my life with the camera. Very cool, very cool. Not only is Mark Jefferson one of the best photographers in the world, he's also my teacher, and one of the reasons I wanted to come to Blackwell. How often do you get to be mentored by one of your inspirations? I've always loved his deco and goth style, and he's so versatile with all his incredible print and advertising work. Still, Jefferson can be a bit condescending. Yeah, I got that. He's pretty hip for his age, but kind of aloof and sometimes pretentious. Yeah, he has this smug smile when he thinks he's right. I fucking know people like this guy, IRL. That's why I don't like him. But I do think he's preparing us for how tough it is to be a full-time artist. He acts like he understands my own work and obsession with analog images. He really wants me to enter a photo in his Everyday Heroes contest, but I've done a good job for avoiding that. The winner gets to fly to San Francisco to represent Blackwell Academy and get national exposure. I'd like to think my work could be good enough to win, and I'm honored Jefferson even bugs me about the contest. Very cool. Wait, is there anything else on him? No, it's just, yeah, okay. Kate. I've forgotten if I've ever seen Kate Marsh smile or laugh in the plasma. Yeah, she was the girl who was being picked on. She's really sweet and nice, even though the other students make fun of her abstinence campaign. Oh, so she's a Christian gal. Even if they act immature, everyone at Blackwell are seniors, not high school freshmen. She gets a lot of shit, in fact. I know she's involved in a lot of religious groups. But she doesn't preach to me, so I don't care. But she's been extra quiet and introverted the past couple of weeks. She looks like she's in zombie mode. I'm worried about her. I wish I could help her, but I can barely help myself. I wonder if all that bullying has worn her down. I can see how it would. I have to make an effort to talk to her more often. Maybe invite her to tea or a movie. Although she's an adult, I bet she's not allowed to watch R-rated films. You know what? I'm gonna make it a personal mission that when I find Kate, I'm gonna help my girl Kate out. Then there's Victoria Chase, the elite of Blackwell Academy, and a total bitch. And I hate saying that. I just don't know why somebody who's so rich and beautiful needs to be so fucking mean. 18-year-olds at a prestigious academy should be evolving into artists and scholars, not reality show contestants. Victoria does everything for maximum drama. She actually wastes her time calling me out in class and taunting Kate Marsh. That's because her parents don't give her enough attention and she wants to draw attention to herself. That's the psychology behind it, at least from what I understand. For reals, I wish her parents could see her in action. They'd cut off that trust fund fast. Then again, she's in the Vortex Club and they seem to own the school, so maybe that's why she doesn't give a shit. The odd thing is that she does know art and photography. She can even say all those French names that break my tongue. Her work is a little cold, but she has a good eye. She also has an eye for Mr. Jefferson, which is so obvious that I'm embarrassed for her. Man, Mr. Jefferson ain't that cool, alright? You girls are fucking... That's all I'm gonna say. She does everything but sit in his lap. He keeps his distance, though. I mean, if Jefferson made a move back, I would be very concerned. We can all tell she's trying to win the Everyday Heroes contest. I'm sure it drives her crazy when there's someone else she can't buy or seduce. Ha. Alright. Nathan. God, he looks like fucking Theo Baker looking ass. Just when I thought Victoria Chase would be the worst of my social problems, now I have to deal with Nathan Prescott. But I guess he was the one who triggered my crazy rewind power by shooting a girl in the bathroom. He's 19 and already a scary fucking prick. And he's a rich fucking prick as well, which means he can get away with it. And he's white, so that helps too. I guess I have a little advantage on Nathan by being able to manipulate time, but if he shoots me, I may not be able to reverse anything. I have to be careful around him, especially since he's obviously got friends in high places, as his family last name is particularly branded on every building here at Blackwell. His money against mine. I have a feeling. Now, I'm going to make a prediction. I think he's going to tell on me. I think he's going to find a way to frame me and... I don't know. On one hand, I do kind of feel bad for Nathan because he doesn't seem to be in control. Like, he's doped up or over-medicated. Fuck that. He's a rich asshole with a gun, alright? There's no excuse for that. On the other hand, he's an asshole. Exactly. Who nobody has called out. And he almost did kill a girl on campus. Should I go straight to the police? Go and find that girl. Use her as a witness. I don't understand. What do I say about my rewind power? Like, I'd say anything. If only this woman had made a video instead of taking a picture of that butterfly art. Like, I'd say anything. I just have to watch my own back from now on. Oh, school days. Fucking cunt-ass David. Look at his Scully flat-top haircut, yaar. Moochard. Whoa, I swear the security guard is the biggest ass here, and that's saying a lot. He always treats everybody like they've committed a crime, or they're about to commit one. He grilled me in the hall today, and I thought he was going to arrest me. Also, I like the fact that they put a fucking Confederate flag underneath his picture. That's fucking hilarious. I thought he was going to arrest me. I don't know much about him, but I heard he was kicked out of the army or something. So, of course, he would end up at Blackwell Academy in charge of security. Aren't you supposed to feel, I don't know, secure on campus? Bro dude swaggers everywhere with that badge and gun like he's looking to tase somebody. He would make a good photo portrait of authority, though. Who does a guy like that marry? I feel sorry for his family. It would be like living in a barrack. Shudder. Just another person I have to avoid at Blackwell. Collect them all. This fucking guy. Look. I don't like police officers. Alright? Me, my family, we don't have good experience with police officers. They, at least in this fucking country, they're all a bunch of fucking prideful cunts waving their badge around like they've got all the... They just use the badge... They fucking abuse their power, use their badge to, like, you know, act like they're in control. Fuck them all. I mean, I might go to prison just for saying that these days, but fuck it, I don't care. Allah malika. Principal. I can't figure out where Principal Wells is coming from. For some reason, he seems to be suspicious of me at all times. Who knew I was that much trouble? He wanted to know why I was zoning out in the halls. I stuttered like a fool. He has so much power over my scholarship, I get uber nervous around him. He kind of looks like Wilson Fisk, doesn't he? I get uber nervous around him. I've seen him laughing with other teachers and students, so I know he must have a problem with me. He also seems a little stressed out. I would be too if I had to oversee Blackwell and all its drama. I thought I smelled alcohol on his breath, but that must have been his cologne, right? I doubt it. But I remember my first meeting in his office, and he was so nice and made me feel like I was being part of a special world. That's what principals do. He said he hoped I would become a great photographer and someday return the favor to Blackwell. I thought that was a bit of wishful thinking, but it made me feel good. I just need to lay low around him until I can somehow gain his trust. Okay. Anyone else? Where's my boy Warren? Oh, he ain't here yet. Let's go through the SMSs. I'm gonna edit this first video, by the way, and I'll skip out the diary reading part. I don't need to include that in. Dad. Have a very special 18th birthday. You're an adult now, but you still are... Okay, let me do the voice for you. Have a special birthday. Have a special 18th birthday. You're an adult now, but you still are a little girl. Check your account. Don't blow it all at once. Thanks, Daddy, for all the money. Oh, my main girl, Kate. Always. You okay? Didn't you want to get tea later today? Absolutely. Was this today? I'm not sure. I'll be free after 4. Talk to you later. Ah, oh, Kate. I'm worried about Kate, yeah. Any interactions that we have with our girl Kate, I'm a big her up, man. That's what I do. Mom. Happy birthday, Maxine. I can't believe it's been 18 whole years since you were brought to us, XO. Stay light on the details there, Mom. And Warren. He kind of has similar hair to me, which makes me like him. Oh, lots of images with him. Pictures, text. Hey! Okay, should I do a voice for him? I'm gonna do the fucking American accent. Hey! Do you want to meet for coffee after school? I need an excuse not to study. Please! Make sure you check Necromantic on my flash drive. Hey, Mad Max. Let's bust shit up. Okay, that's a lot of unreplied messages. Wait! I have to study for a physics class. So if we bust anything, we also have to measure its velocity. Don't ignore this message. Hey, Max, can you get my flash drive? Okay, I'll stop. I need some info in space. Hello? Sorry, running late, insane day. I'll meet you in the lot, looking cool. You'll see, my camera will be ready. See you shortly, I hope so. I haven't met this guy yet, but I'm just gonna picture that's what he sounds like.
Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive.
We shall grab that flash drive in the next video. I'm gonna edit this video, by the way. I won't edit the other ones, but I'll edit the fucking journal reading part out. So, I mean, it's not like you guys are gonna hear that anyways. And since I'm editing this video, you probably won't even see this part either. I mean, hell, I could say the N-word if I wanted to. Later.